Alright, right back with you on the Rich Van Tassel channel, continuing with our NBA preview, the top 50 players we have today, 21 through 30. I'm going to start at number 21, the power forward for the Cleveland Cavaliers, Kevin Love. A lot was made last season about Kevin Love, his relationship with LeBron James. They're still together this year, and we're going to see if they can cash out and cash that in for a championship. Obviously, Kevin Love was hurt last year in the playoffs, but that's a bit beside the point as of right now. Kevin Love is still a spectacular rebounder. He's a very good three-point shooter, and while you'd like to see him develop a bit more of a post game, he can get the job done down in the post, and I think he'll be more comfortable with the Cavs in this offense this season. So there it is, Kevin Love at number 21. Look for him to have a bounce back year and a very good season this year, I'm expecting. At number 22, the newly acquired point guard for the Houston Rockets, Ty Lawson. Very underrated guy, never really got the publicity he was due in Denver. George Karl certainly loved him when they were together in Denver. And Ty Lawson, we talked about John Wall being the fastest player in the league. Certainly Ty Lawson might make a case for that as well. He averaged 15 points per game, which is pretty good for a point guard, nothing spectacular. Was just under 10 assists last year, though, at 9.6 assists per game. It's very good, and you would expect those numbers to go up now that he's playing with a Dwight Howard and a James Harden. And I'm really looking for him to push that team really to title contention this year. I'm expecting big things for Ty Lawson this year, and I think he'll be freed up to really make plays up and down the court in that Houston offense. So look out for Ty Lawson this year. Number 22, a lot of talk about this, being how low he was on ESPN's rankings. I'm not going to disrespect him that much, and that's Kobe Bryant. Excuse me, at 23 is Kobe Bryant, of course, the shooting guard for the Los Angeles Lakers. I only have him this low because he's coming back from injuries, and we got to see how that will affect him. But Kobe Bryant, if he's healthy, this guy will still put up 25 points per game. And I know this because Kobe Bryant has made it clear he will not step on the court if he doesn't feel his game is up to the caliber he expects of himself. So assuming he's healthy, I mean, obviously if an injury happens, then that's a problem. But you just need to take Kobe's word for it because he's the type of guy, he's that proud, that he will not step on the court and if his game isn't up to caliber. So look for at least 23 points per game this season. Whether, if it requires him shooting, you know, 35 shots a game, he will do it. But I don't ever doubt Kobe for one second. He's one of the all-time greats, and I'm expecting him to have a bounce back year this year. So we only have him down that far at 23 because of the injuries. Up next at 24, we have the center for the Los Angeles Clippers. That's DeAndre Jordan, a spectacular defensive player. He does average over 11 points per game, but a lot of those are off dunks. He does get 15 rebounds per game and 2.2 blocks per game. He's really an anchor of that defense. Doc Rivers compares him, wants him to be like Kevin Garnett was when they were together in Boston, and he's going to have to continue to do that. You'd really like to see his free throw shooting improve so he can stay on the court in big moments, and that's one thing that really hampers him. If you're not on the court, it doesn't matter how good you are, you can't really be helping your team. But that's more of the value discussion than it is just how good a player is. But DeAndre Jordan is a very good defensive player, and he gets the points that he needs. He doesn't shoot many shots. It's all off, you know, alley-oops and stuff. They're really not running offense for him, so he's not even hindering the offense, you know, looking for his shot and trying to figure it out. The only way he hurts him offensively is with his free throw shooting, so you'd like to see that improve. But there it is at 24. That's DeAndre Jordan. At 25, we have Carmelo Anthony, who should be right at about 25 points again this season. I think Carmelo shoots too much, but he is a very tough cover. If there's anyone who could make the case for a tougher cover in the league than James Harden, it would be Carmelo Anthony. When he's focused defensively, he is a good defender. He's that big. He's that athletic. He can, you know, certainly, while you wouldn't mark him up on post guys, he can certainly handle his own if he's ever caught in a switch or on transition or anything like that in a pick and roll, defending post guys in, you know, down on the block. But his main, you know, his bread is buttered on the offensive end. We'll see if that team gets better in the triangle offense. And Carmelo continues to learn in that triangle offense. He was hurt a lot last year. That's why the Knicks were as bad as they were. Again, you know, does he shoot too much? Probably. But, you know, so does Kobe Bryant. And Kobe Bryant's an all-time great. So, you know, I'm not the biggest Carmelo Anthony fan, but I don't think everything is fair to pin on him. So we'll see how he does this year, but if the Knicks have another poor season, then you don't know what to say about him. But again, we'll get into that in the season previews. Number 26, a guy I've really liked for a couple years now, does not get a lot of publicity. They had a good year last year, so that's certainly put him on the map a bit more. But that's Jeff Teague, the point guard for the Atlanta Hawks. Averaged just under 16 points and 7 rebounds per game. A guy who, again, is another fast point guard. Really looks to get up and down the court in transition. His shooting could improve. He's not a bad shooter, but the better shooter you are, obviously, the better offensive player you will be. And especially with that lightning quick speed he has, if you can shoot, he becomes a very tough defend, especially in a pick and roll game with an Al Horford. So, sorry about that. That's Jeff Teague for you at 26. Look for him to continue to improve this year. At 27, Al Jefferson of the Charlotte Hornets, the power forward slash center. Al Jefferson is a guy who can really break you down in the post. He's put up 40-point games. He's had monster games in his career. You'd like to see him, if he could shoot better from the outside, he'd be very dangerous in the pick and roll. He's a good defender, rebound, gets over a block per game, so he's not a liability on the defensive end, but for his size, you'd like to see him improve a bit in that department. But again, this is a guy who's 30 years old. He basically is what he is. But a couple years ago when Charlotte made that run to the playoffs after being a terrible team, he was a guy who had a very good year that year, made an All-NBA team. So he's a very good player. Again, you just like to see him shoot a bit more, be a bit more focused on the defensive end. But if Charlotte's going to go anywhere, it's going to be on the back of Al Jefferson, as well as Kemba Walker. 28, Kawhi Leonard, the reigning defensive player of the year, the small forward shooting guard from the San Antonio Spurs. For as good of a defensive player he is, he's also a 48% shooter from the floor, which is quite good for a small forward shooting guard. But his best attribute is his defense. He can... There's certain guys like a LeBron James no one can lock down, but Kawhi Leonard can defend everybody in the league. So he can lock down most guys and certainly compete well against the LeBron James. So is he the best wing defender in the league? There are other guys who would make an argument, you know, a la Tony Allen, who we'll get into. He'll certainly be on this list at some point. But Kawhi Leonard's certainly up there, and he will be in consideration for Defensive Player of the Year again this year. So that's 28, Kawhi Leonard. 29, a guy who certainly doesn't get much publicity at all playing out in Utah, but that's Gordon Hayward, the small forward shooting guard from the Utah Jazz. Gordon Hayward averaged 19.3 points per game, but his points per game have improved every season since he's been in the league. This is a guy who is a good one-on-one player, can get his shot at any time. He's not really a good rebounder as you would like for a guy who's 6'8", so he'd have to improve in that department. But again, we talked about it. He's improved every year. His scoring has gone up, and you know, quite vastly, especially from his first to second year and his second to third years. Obviously, when you start scoring, you know, in 19-point areas, you can only improve so much. But I expect it to still go up, and him to be a 20-point scorer this year. And if his defense and rebounding can improve, this is a guy who would be an outside contender for an All-NBA team. So watch for Gordon Hayward this year. He's at 29, and at number 30. I have Bradley Beal, the shooting guard for the Washington Wizards. He runs that 1-2 punch with John Wall. He was injured a lot last year. I think that really hurt them getting the seeding they wanted in the playoffs. And certainly when John Wall went down, he was the guy who had to carry a bulk of the scoring in the playoffs when John Wall was absent. This is a guy who, you know, is a right at about 40% three-point shooting. His field goal percentage in general, though, is only about 42%. So that's something you would like to see him improve on. His defense, he's 6'5". He's got the ability to play good defense. I don't think he necessarily brings it on a night-to-night basis, but certainly he has the capability to mark up any shooting guard he wants. And even if you had to put him on a small forward, you could probably get away with it in certain switches because he is a big guy. So we'll see how he responds from the injury this year, but that's Bradley Beal rounding out the top 30. For Bradley Beal of the Washington Wizards rounding out the top 30. So there it is. Tomorrow we will continue with 31 through 40, getting towards the end of that. Come Monday, we'll give you a breakdown of the conferences, see how that shapes up, and then Tuesday we'll do the same thing as well as the prediction, you know, the playoff predictions and MVP awards. So be sure to stay tuned for the 31 to 40 tomorrow, and then continuing with the NBA previews with the teams and how they do. And in just a couple moments, we will have the San Francisco 49ers and Seattle Seahawks tonight's game breakdown for you. Thank you.